88,000 people on the list for social housing. And if you can believe it, the waiting list for that is 2.5 years to 21 years. I actually had a shiver go down through me. It's such a shocking, shocking thing to imagine. These people need a decent place to live, and we need that too. This is a cost to Toronto, it's a cost to Ontario, it's a cost to Canada when you have people who are not living properly and are unable to live productively as well. So we need a federal housing strategy, and we've long needed this strategy, one that sets national goals on housing creation and affordability, and puts in place long-term sustainable funding flows to ensure that these goals get realized. And again, so do our fellow city dwellers in Edmonton and Fredericton and St. John's. The other area that I'd like to touch on is immigration. And we in Toronto are probably more aware of this than others because we are a city that's almost 50% foreign-born. But immigrants have really built this entire country and are the key to our future economic growth. I think Kevin's statistics pointed to immigration being that's going to be our population growth, but it's also our economic growth. It's also a huge advantage that we have in Canada, and in particular here. It really sets us apart from every other part of the world. And I think I've probably been boring my colleagues and other people by talking about some work I've done with new colleagues in Europe. And in Europe, in people from Germany will talk about third-generation migrants. Mm-hmm. And they kept saying this, and I said, who are you talking about? What's a third-generation migrant? I realized I'm a second-generation migrant. But the whole mindset we have around immigration here is so positive, and it's so welcoming and inclusive. It's not perfect by any stretch, but it's way better than other parts of the world. But we can't be complacent in thinking that other parts of the world aren't looking very hard at Canada and at Toronto and thinking, how do we get some of that too? And in addition, some of the new research shows that other countries are going to be going after the very same migrants that we've been going after. So if we think we're a magnet for immigrants, we shouldn't underestimate its strength, and we need to protect that. The federal government obviously plays a huge role in immigration, but we need them to explicitly recognize how critical immigrants are to the success of our cities. The work that we did for our summit showed that there are a series of stages that go on in bringing immigrants to Canada. It goes from recruiting people in countries very far away to the procedure that they go through to get here, once they land, how they get settled as a family, how they get settled in work. And that really those pieces do not fit together at all well. And I think probably most of you are familiar with the horrible stories you hear about people coming with skills that aren't being deployed. But it really is an issue. We do not have a connection between our labor needs and what's being recruited for overseas. And that's one of the things that really needs to get fixed. We also need a federal government that will properly support immigrants as they settle themselves and their families here and as they integrate into our economy. This includes leveraging things like their entrepreneurial talents, which is something that, a big recommendation that came out of our summit. And we've seen it done in other parts of the world. Barcelona, is one example. They have a 24-hour entrepreneur support place that has language services of 18 different languages. So if you come to Barcelona and you want to set up a business 3 in the morning, they're there for you. Something we could be doing fairly easily, and we're going to actually be working with some partners to try and do that. The other thing that I've been very surprised to realize is that in Ontario, which has always been the immigrant capital, we're actually getting about 20% fewer immigrants than we have in the past. And the people we're getting are less skilled. So other provinces, they get immigrants, but 25% of them are skilled. Our average is 16%. And we're getting many fewer economic class immigrants. And those are the people who come and create businesses and hire and many other people. Part of this is probably because of us. We other people hear about experiences in the Toronto region, and they say, well, I'll go try my luck in Vancouver, Alberta. But part of it is also to the immigration agreement that our province has with the federal government, or had, I should say had, because it actually expired March 31st. It got extended by a year, expired March 31st, and the ministers right now aren't talking to each other, which is pretty horrific. Other provinces have much better immigration agreements, and in fact, they're sort of skimming off a lot of the best people looking at Canada, and they're going directly to other provinces and not coming here. govern this, and we certainly can't rely on any future money. And again, this matters to us, but it also matters to other city dwellers, because as Kevin pointed out, cities, metro areas, we're calling it metro areas, are home to 90% of Canada's immigrants. So I'm going to close my remarks here. I'm looking around this room. I see people who are far more expert.